Hello, welcome back, and nice to see you again. So far, we have discussed systemic and group-related explanations which have been developed to understand what can go wrong with transposition and implementation. But what about the role of policymakers, including implementers themselves? Do they support European policymaking? In today's lecture, we focus on the interest of domestic policymakers as a cause of the problems with transposition and implementation. While some national policymakers may participate in the European decision-making process, others have not. Imperfections in representation and domestic coordination contribute to the situation. In addition, the decisions made at the European level are a compromise between many actors, including other member states, Parliament and the Commission. As a consequence, decisions do not necessarily reflect the preferences at the national level or the level at which implementation takes place. This is a simple but inevitable consequence of European policymaking. How can we understand domestic decision-making on European policy? The veto player theory, which was initially proposed by George Tsubelis, offers a first perspective on this matter. In this theory, political systems consist of a number of legislative decision-makers whose support is required to pass a proposal. If one of these decision-makers disagrees with a new policy, she has the power to veto a decision. This makes a policymaker a veto player. When the decision is vetoed, the state of affairs remains the same or becomes a default situation, which is called the status quo. In case of transposition, this default situation is often seen as the literal interpretation of a directive. In case of implementation, the default is implementing the European policy as formulated. The second element of the theory is players' preferences. The main hypothesis of this theory is that more players with different preferences or more differences in preferences for a fixed number of players will lead to more instances of deadlock. In case of transposition, this is often associated with more delay, which has been found in some empirical work. In case of implementation, it may affect the discretion of implementing authorities, as we will discuss now. The veto player theory is an important tool to understand decision making, but suffers from some limitations. First, the initial formulation of the theory relied on formal legislative players. Often, other non-legislative actors exist that may block decision making, such as interest groups like employer organizations and strongly cooperative systems. Therefore, the set of players needs to include informal players. Another limitation is that having veto rights is just one power next to others. The possibility of drafting a proposal, as reflected in agenda setting rights, may be more important than blocking decision making. Another power is gatekeeping rights, when a player can submit a proposal to another for a final decision. An example is the Commission, which may submit an infringement case to the Court of Justice. Another perspective is offered by the multi-level drift theory, as developed by Antoinette Dimitrova and myself. This points to the limitations on policymakers at different decision-making levels to fully control the behavior of others at the lower level. The theory departs from three different levels at which decisions on transposition and implementation are made. The first is the European level, at which the Commission monitors the domestic policy process. Since monitoring is costly, which we discussed before, the Commission is indifferent to some deviations from the European policy as indicated by Q. This set is called the indifferent set, which is indicated here in red. The second level is national transposition, at which domestic policymakers adopt the national transposing policy. Allowing these policymakers to act as veto players, with V1 and V2 as the most extreme players, they prefer the policy as transposed to be in their domestic unanimity set. This set is indicated here in green. Furthermore, to avoid triggering a response from the Commission, the domestic policy is also in the Commission's indifferent set. Since both sets overlap, national policymakers have some discretion. depending on who is the domestic agenda setter, that choice could be the slightly deviating transposed policy P star. The third level is implementation, which could be at the national level, but also at the regional or local levels within a member state. The implementing authority will now search for its best policy choice given Commission oversight and oversight by the domestic policymakers. This requires a choice within the indifference set as well as the domestic unanimity set. Since these sets overlap, the implementing authority may set its implementing policy to P double star as indicated. Alternatively, if implementation is delegated to several decision makers, which may act as veto players, the policy choice may be dependent on the implementing player with agenda setting power. Interestingly, this theory predicts different responses from the domestic players depending on their preferences. While the preference configuration illustrates the case of domestic adaptation, in other outcomes, players select different policies or are constrained by the Commission. In the case of incidental compliance, the preferences of various actors align so that the transposed as well as the implemented policy fully reflect European policy, see here. Some deviation occurs in the case of formal compliance when the implementing actors use their discretion and adopt a different implementing policy. In the case of imposed formal compliance, the domestic and implementing actors are constrained by the policy that the Commission, as overseeing player, is about to accept. This results in transposed and implementing policies that deviate from the European policy but are not close to the ideal positions of the domestic actors. The behavioral theories on transposition and implementation discussed in this lecture present a more detailed account of how domestic actors may sometimes use their discretion in order to adopt different policies as transposed or policies as implemented. The use of these possibilities are conditional on Commission oversight and oversight, in the case of implementation, by national actors. From an empirical perspective, these theories require a lot of information, including identifying relevant actors as well as the preferences of these actors. This makes testing the implications beyond the number of case studies more difficult. The question is, which factors may apply in your research on implementation? We turn to this in your dossier on one of the selected European policies. Before doing so, I would like to discuss one other issue, and that is the way in which member states involve regional and local governments. Let's have a look in the next lecture.